Welcome back. The wheels of justice continue to turn even in the midst of a pandemic. The courts have remained open, at least in a limited capacity, but now as more in-person services resume, new requirements are being rolled out.
I hope people realize we haven't closed. We've been here the whole time and that we aren't opening up overnight either.
Amy Love is with the Maricopa County Superior Court, where they have limited in-person services since the start of the pandemic and halted all jury selections.
In that first week, I think, of the pandemic, we saw a 40% reduction of our foot traffic across the superior courts in Maricopa, which is pretty significant when you realize we're the fourth largest trial court in the country.
But now, as the state reopens, the courts too are looking for how to best balance their proceedings with public health.
Some people will say justice delayed is justice denied, and we're very cognizant of that.
Since March, most business has been postponed or conducted on the phone, with only limited in-person services available.
For the people that are coming to our courthouse, most of the time, you don't really have a choice. You've either been summoned to be there by our jury administrator, or perhaps by, if you're involved in a court case, whether it's, a divorce or an eviction.
Given that, the Chief Justice has ordered all people who work and visit courts across the state to wear a mask and undergo a health and temperature screening. Additionally, jurors are now scheduled to come back June 15th, 2 weeks away. But that too will look different with social distancing.
The general public won't be able to just walk in and sit in a courtroom because we're actually going to be using the typical gallery space for the public to move to space the jurors in some of the rooms.